You know, at some point in your relationship, I know you were trying to figure out some way to make your guy worry about losing you in the relationship, right? Am I right or am I right here? You know what happens. Eventually, he just doesn't pay as much attention to you. He doesn't make you feel like the priority you once were, and you're just sick of it. You want him to make you that priority again. Well, that's what we're gonna talk about today. We're gonna talk about ways that you can make him worry about losing you and this relationship. And hey, if you like this stuff, why not like and subscribe? It's awesome content. I give it to you every week for free. And number two, make sure you turn on the notification, that little bell indicator next to the subscribe button, so you know when the next video comes out. And of course, if you have any questions or if you want to suggest a video, do that in the comments section below. I suppose if it comes down to anything, it's going to be this idea that you just don't want to be taken for granted, right? I mean, you want a relationship that feels like it's a two-way street, and you want this guy to be there with you in it 100%. I totally get it. And that's why I'm telling you about this stuff. I know that everybody, every woman has had that at some point in her relationship. Relationships can be a little hard to handle sometimes, especially if you're with a guy who's not ready to change his mind and really go forward with a commitment to the relationship. But here's an ugly truth I gotta tell you right up front. What you're trying to do is probably not working, right? A lot of women go into a relationship and they want to prove themselves. They want to show him that they can be the best possible woman. They want to be the best possible partner. You do the natural nurturing thing, and what happens? He takes you for granted. Now, that happens because you're good to him. You're too good to him, and you got to back off a little bit. See, giving a guy everything he wants is not the way to win his heart. It doesn't work that way. That's not what makes a person fall in love with another person. I guarantee it. And if you've ever had a guy that pursued you relentlessly and was a little too, I don't know, insecure and needy and wanted you so bad he did anything for you, what did you think? Yeah, you thought this guy was pathetic and you really didn't want to have anything to do with him. The first most important thing you got to do is don't sit around hoping that this guy is just going to change on his own and he's going to finally wake up and figure out what you mean to him. It doesn't happen that way. Guys don't just suddenly realize this stuff. Typically, the only way that happens is if you break up with him and then he realizes it. And you don't want to have to go that far, right? So the very first thing you got to do is you got to get busy with your life. If you're waiting on a guy to complete you, you're always going to be incomplete. It's just a simple fact of life. And again, the reason you're doing this is because you want to be a little bit unavailable. You've got to have a certain amount of scarcity. Think about it. What is scarce in life is basically the stuff that we appreciate. The things that are hard to come by, we appreciate when we can get them, right? Like the reservations at your favorite restaurant. If you could get in there at any time, you'd take it for granted. You would just figure, oh, we can just show up there. Let's try someplace else. You inevitably start to feel more interested in going to a restaurant that's harder to get into. And why is that? What happens there? What makes that restaurant so much more appealing is because if you can't get into it and get that food, if there's something holding you back, well, that's telling your psychology that there must be something valuable about it. There must be some reason that it's scarce. And this scarcity principle is used everywhere. It's used in advertising. It's used in pretty much everything. Just keep in mind that if you're a little bit scarce, he's going to value you more. It's inevitable. It always happens that way. You see, there's this kind of unspoken rule for women. It's like a law that women are expected to give and give and give and be patient with their man until the ends of the earth. And if you try to be some kind of impossible angel out there that makes this guy realize that you're the best woman in the world, he's going to fall in love with you, he's going to desire you so much, he's going to propose, you're going to have this happy life, blah, blah, blah. The reality is, by doing that, you're being even less scarce to him. In other words, he has no way to value you. We only value things that we understand the value for. In other words, if something's hard to come by, we know it must be valuable on some level. That's why you're probably not being taken seriously and why he's taking you for granted right now and why you're not his priority. And guess what? He's never going to worry about losing a woman who's always there for him, who's always helping him, who always lets him walk all over her, who always, you see what I'm saying, right? That just doesn't work in your favor. Because you'd be giving him even more room to continue that kind of self-serving behavior. You'd be making it even easier as time goes on, and he's just not going to value you. In fact, it's going to reduce his emotional interest in you. He will love you less because you're being too good to him. If you've ever heard that from a guy, you know what I mean. Some guys will say to you that those specific words, you're being too nice to me, you're too good to me. What does that mean? If we valued it, we wouldn't care how good they were. We'd want to eat that up and have it for dinner, breakfast, everything. So the only thing you can do really to make sure that a man maintains his feeling of scarcity for you is be a little unavailable. Go out and do other things. Make your life a priority. You've probably heard that bit of advice a lot on the internet, right? I'm sure you've been searching for other stuff. It's okay. I don't feel cheated on. But of course, now that you've come to Carlos, you're going to get the real straight truth, which is if you're going out there and being too available for him, he just can't appreciate you. So don't be passive. Don't wait for things to happen to you. This is my next little rule for you to make him worry about losing you, is don't be passive and wait around for him to suddenly realize this stuff. He's never going to figure out on his own. You have to show it to him in a way that he understands. It's called the language of male psychology, and it works. It works every time. This is what I specialize in teaching women. Now, another rule that you got to use is you've got to match him without overrunning him. In other words, the amount of energy that you're putting into your relationship is kind of like this. You've got on one side, there's you. On there's one side, there's him. And somehow men always seem to fall a little bit below what they really need to be for you, right? Just a little bit less, which makes you do what? Work a little harder. And maybe it comes up a little less, or maybe it goes down a little bit lower. But it never does this. The only way it does this is if you do this, okay? It's not logical, it's not rational, but it's human psychology, it's human nature, and that doesn't change, friends. It does not change. So match him, but don't overrun him. In other words, meet the level of energy that he's putting out. Because in the start, a man should be putting out this much, right? To begin with, he should be working to win you over. Don't go past him. Stay a little bit less, and he will work a little harder to try and pull you up to his level. It works every single time, and it's one of the most valuable dynamics in dating that you can learn. Give him enough space that he can miss you, that he can feel like there's something valuable there for him to come to. Next up, are you needy? Are you a little bit on the more anxious end of the spectrum? Typically, there's two ends of the spectrum. On one side, there's anxious. On the other side, there's aloof. Okay? Anxious, aloof. Guess who's on which side? That's right. Guys tend to be on the aloof side. Only because, by our nature, we just don't show a lot of emotions. We don't put out a lot in terms of emotional communication. We keep that internal, even though we're feeling just as much as you are, sometimes way more. It's amazing sometimes how much emotion is going through a guy, especially when he's walking up and trying to talk to you or ask you out on a date or win you over. When a guy's in that win you over mode, you got to work that. That's where he's going to have that energy to put into the relationship. And that's how you lock a guy in. It's in those early 90-day stage, right where you have those first few dates. And by the way, if you don't get him won over in that time period, that's where you run into this problem of not being able to feel like he's making you a priority, where you're the one who's always working to try and make him value you. This is where you're the one who's always worrying about losing him because he never seems like he's there. So if you're over on the anxious side of the end of the spectrum, which tends to be most women, because women have a much more dynamic need for interaction to feel that connection with somebody. For a woman, the connection is everything. And you get that from other women, right? It's fairly easy to get. With guys, not so much, which makes you work a little harder and the energy goes up and up and up. Now, if that anxious energy turns into neediness or desperation or any of those kinds of behaviors that you know you might be putting out from time to time, that stuff doesn't go away just because you find a guy that loves you. I know a lot of women think this, that if you just love him enough and you get him to love you back just the right amount, that will make you feel good and you'll lose all those feelings of neediness and insecurity and desperation. Guess what happens though? It doesn't happen that way. If you find a guy that does love you, what happens is your insecurity will just grow up to the level of where you're at in that relationship. That's the way it works. You're going to find some reason to feel insecure about it until you conquer those feelings of insecurity. Again, this is something I show you how to do through understanding men and understanding your relationships with men and how to make them happen. When you have the security that you know you can create a relationship with a guy and you don't have to worry about him looking at other women or being interested in another relationship or pulling away from you and making you feel that aching panic, when you know that you can do that and you have the understanding to do that, you're going to be so much more secure in your relationships, and you're going to create that dynamic I'm talking about where he works to win you over. Okay, here's another big tip in how to make him worry about your relationship is to restructure the relationship. Now, what do I mean by that? Restructuring your relationship is where you redefine what your relationship is and how you two work together. See, here's what normally happens. When you start dating a guy, what do? You go out on a date, maybe it's a Saturday night, and then you go out on another Saturday night or a Saturday, but you typically go out with him on weekends. So that becomes your pattern. Now you start to repeat those patterns and hope that those patterns grow. And you never let go of the pattern. You just keep sticking to it. You hope it keeps growing so that you see him every day of the week, and eventually he moves in, and eventually he proposes to you, and eventually you live happily ever after. But the reality is that pattern doesn't always increase, does it? You get to kind of this critical mass, this place where he stops putting in the energy and he starts to back off, he starts to move away, and that's where the panic comes into the relationship. You've got to be the one to initiate what I call the restructure. This is where you change and redefine that pattern of how you date. It's really easy how to do it too. Now, the way you restructure your relationship is very simple. It's really a process of rebuilding how he thinks about you and what he thinks about your relationship. You've got to shake things up to a certain degree. Change the pattern. This is the easiest way to do it, and I'll talk about more of these little simple ways to do this in my programs. But the easiest way is to simply change up the date of when you guys go out. Early on enough, you want to do that. You want to make sure that you're not going out and seeing each other on the same day of the week. This gives it a sort of, not an instability, but a sort of irregularity about it. So it doesn't feel too repetitive. It doesn't become something that he just gets used to, especially when he wants to make it very frequent. He wants to make that pattern frequent because to a guy, that makes him feel secure in a relationship. And what this does is if you can't be available on the days that he wants you to be, well, that shows that you've got your own life. This shows that bit of scarcity that tells him you're a valuable person, you're a valuable commodity, you're a woman who is high value. And one thing I want you to never do is to rearrange your week or restructure your life to accommodate his availability. When you do that, you've taken the first step into over accommodating him. This is where he realizes, oh, dude, I've totally got her. She's totally won over. I don't have to work at this anymore. When a guy thinks that, you've lost the relationship. You've become just another repetitive pattern to him, and you can't do that. Now, you might be wondering, hey, Carlos, is this guy maybe the emotionally unavailable type? Is that why he's never worried about losing me? He just doesn't care? That's always possible, but here's something that most women don't know. Most guys are emotionally available. It's how you open those emotions up and how you get him to express them. Most women have no clue how to do this. They don't understand men. They don't know what makes men tick in order to make his emotions available to her. So if you don't know that stuff, of course he's going to be emotionally unavailable to you. He's going to be commitment phobic. That happens naturally when you don't know how to get him to open up. Look, you want him to make you happy. You want him to work on your relationship, and you want to know that there's a future with him, don't you? You gotta want that. Every woman wants that. And the only way to know that is to know how to get a man to open up, to be able to feel those emotions with you and express them, to tell you how he feels, to put the energy into the relationship that you need. Do you want to know this stuff? Well, you can find out, and you can find out right away. Here's how you do it. It's real easy. Go to this link you see below me here. That's right. datingfire.com/does he love me. datingfire.com/does he love me. It's a very quick, simple quiz that will tell you if this guy is salvageable. Can you save this relationship? Does he really love you enough that he's going to stick around and eventually be the guy that's going to worry about losing you? So go on over to datingfire.com/does he love me. It's a quick 10-question quiz. Go through it, blast through it quick, and then you also will get my free ebook on the 7 mistakes that women make that push men away. If you've ever wondered why guys are always pulling away from your relationships, I'm going to tell you exactly what those things are. Go on over and get it now, datingfire.com/does he love me. Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo from datingfire.com and datingadviceguru.com. As always, this is the stuff I want to bring you every single week. And if you want more of it, make sure you do the like and subscribe. You stuck around this long. Why wouldn't you do that? Number two, make sure you turn on the notifications so you know when the next video comes out. And if you have any suggestions of what you'd like me to talk about, by all means, put that down in the comment section below. This is Carlos Cavallo. As always, live and love with passion.